Hey everyone, it's Mike Ball from WordPress.com. Today we're going to take a look at how to browse and navigate themes on WordPress. So we have on WordPress.com a slightly different experience than if you have a self-hosted WordPress site somewhere else. We're always going to start with just WordPress.com, which should take you to your kind of homepage for your site. If you have multiple sites, you might have to select which one you want to be working on. Right now you can see I have the Pango Life site selected. So we're going to go here on this left sidebar and we're going to go down to Appearance and we're going to choose Themes. And right out of the gate, you're going to get a selection of really popular themes that exist across WordPress.com and are available. You obviously have your search bar. You can jump from trending to themes that maybe you've already used or all themes that are in here. Right now, I'm going to open up, let's say, the feature filter. And I'm going to look for full site editing because that's the kind of feature set that came out in WordPress 5.9. That means that theme is going to be a block theme and I'm going to have all the features that I really like to have in terms of color and layout and my templates that I want to play around with. So blank canvas is just an empty theme that you can build on top of. And then we have all these other ones that come with essentially templates designed for you and content to let you work off of. With full site editing and with WordPress in general, your theme is really kind of the structure of all the different settings. So you can start from blank and do all those settings on your own, or you can pick a theme that you like, and it's kind of like taking a shortcut to get to a layout or a design that you really want. So when I'm browsing through here, I can see kind of a thumbnail preview of what that theme looks like. That doesn't give you a ton of information, so I'm going to want to dig deeper before I choose one and change the entire look of my site. Let's say I go here and check out this preview a little bit so I can see a little bit longer view of how that homepage looks and kind of the color scheme. I can also see kind of how it scales over here across desktop, mobile, and tablet screens. I can expand that if I need to or zoom in. So I can activate, if I like this design, I can activate this design. If I'm still not sure after kind of the magnified preview, I can open a live demo of the site. And this lets you not just scroll around like I was doing before, but it actually lets you click around on the site and see the different pages that kind of exist here. This gives you an idea of different components that maybe you didn't see in that homepage. Like, oh, hey, it's got a nice pattern for a newsletter sign up. It's got a cool three column layout in here. It's even got some event information patterns that are built into it. Important to remember, all these patterns you can actually pull from WordPress.org and insert in the editor via kind of the pattern selector, but the theme is really just, do you like the look and feel of this? Does it have the elements that you want in it? Is that going to save you enough time? If you're new to WordPress and you're building your first site, themes are super helpful. If you have done this a million times and you know exactly what you want and you're not finding a theme that looks right, it might just be better for you to jump in and build it yourself. So you can go through this process and essentially activate the theme that you like. That'll take your content on your existing site and basically apply these styles to it and give you the templates and template layouts that exist. So be aware, if you already have a full site editing enabled site or a block theme and you've done a bunch of work to customize that, make sure when you go back in the right templates are selected and it looks the way that you want it to look and expect when you do this. If you're worried about switching themes, you can always use a backup and restore from a backup if you don't like how it turns out and can't get things back to the way you want. That's just an easy kind of undo button.